Hey everybody, what's up? Coming to you from the most random location to date. I'm in a mall in the great city of Fresno, California, the one and only, before it opens. So if you see me looking around like this, it's because I don't know if I'm supposed to be here or not. Long story, most of it involves the wind that is tearing through Fresno, California today. But I'm here to talk to you about the USC football program. USC is going to be hit with some stiff sanctions. They're going to be hammered with some sanctions. And by the way, you might see people walking around from time to time. I guess they walk in these malls, so just have to deal with it. Bear with me. You're going to have to focus here. USC is going to be hit, hammered with some sanctions. Two-year postseason ban, the loss of 20 scholarships. They might have to have their wins from the 2004 season revoked, up to 20 wins. So this is a pretty substantial penalty for USC. This is damaging. You know, most people don't pay attention to the wins that are revoked. They look at the NCAA as the machine, and just because the NCAA says one thing doesn't mean you have to pay attention to it. So if they revoke those wins, in the minds of most people, they'll still refer to USC as the champions from the 2004 season. So aside from that, you got to look at from this point going forward. You look at the future. And when you talk about all the negative recruiting in college football, teams are going to say to these USC recruits, why you want to go there? They're not going to be in bowl games for 2 years. They can't even compete for a national championship. Why do you want to go there? Plus, you talk about the Pac-10 maybe being the Pac-16. Sorry, a little distracted by this music. I don't know what it is. You know, if I own a mall, I'm going to have the first heavy metal only mall. But that's beside the point. If you look at the Pac-10 growing to maybe the Pac-16, you're going to have even more teams saying those things about USC. So, and then losing scholarships on top of the negative recruiting. So the recruits that you do get, you might not have enough scholarships to get more guys that you want. This is very damaging for USC. And the other thing you got to keep in mind, a lot of people think that USC is just bulletproof. They're not. USC is not bulletproof. Ever since Pete Carroll has had it cranked up for the last 7 years or so, they're rattling off 11, 12 win seasons like it's no big deal. And you think that's the way it's always been with USC. It hasn't. There was a span of 21 seasons before Pete Carroll got it cranked up where USC never won 10 games. They didn't have a double-digit winning season for 21 straight years. So don't make it seem like, USC just gonna brush this off, no big deal. This is a very, very damaging penalty for USC. And it's one that they could feel for a lot of years. I'm Brian Noe, and that's a very random no-brainer.